Welcome to this Odin AI tutorial. In this video, we'll be building a recruitment assistant that helps you source candidate profiles directly from LinkedIn using Odin AI. We'll also be talking about what flows and triggers are, how you can build and test your flow, and how you can use Odin Action to run your automations. In our previous video, we discussed how you can create a project, configure a custom agent, and set up your knowledge base, and we put all of that together to build a customer support chatbot. So if you haven't watched that video, be sure to go check it out. To search and fetch LinkedIn URLs directly on our Odin chat, we are going to be using Odin's flows. So let's talk about what flows are. Flows are a series of actions that automate your tasks. Think of them as a set of instructions for Odin to follow. You can find flows under the automated option on the left panel. When you click on new flow, you'll notice there are two ways to build your flow. One is to use any of the pre-populated templates that we have on Odin, and the other one is to build a flow from scratch. For this video, we will be building a flow from scratch, and another way to do that is to go to Odin Actions and then click Create, as this will bring you directly to the Flow Builder screen. Every flow on Odin has a trigger, and triggers are basically events or specific conditions that can set off your flows. Triggers can be automatic or manual, or you can even schedule your workflows to begin at a specific time. Here you'll notice that Odin Action has been selected as the trigger by default, which is great because for this flow, that's exactly what we'll be using. Let's give our action a name, and this is the exact name that will appear on our Actions tab later. I'm going to call this the Recruitment Helper. And now let's give it a description of what we want the flow to do. For this flow, we will have to specify what kind of profiles we're looking for so that we can narrow down our search. And for that, we'll need a field to be able to input that information. So let's go ahead and add a field, and again, similarly configure that as well. Now let's quickly test our trigger with some mock data. Testing individual pieces is not only important to make sure that your flow is working exactly as intended, it's also great for rectifying something that we might have missed out on earlier. Now that this is tested successfully, we can go ahead and add our second step of the flow, which is an Odin AI agents piece. We are going to be using this piece to translate our simple input query into something that's more optimized as a search term. Let's set the action to instruct Odin AI. And let's pick the agent we want to use for this step. You'll notice all Odin's default agents are listed under the agents dropdown, but if you have any custom agents on your profile, they will also appear here. Let's select the AI simple agent. And let's insert the search query from our trigger and use a set of detailed prompts to guide it towards what our expected output is going to be. Let's pick a format for this response. We're going to be using a normal text output. And now let's test this step. Our third step is going to be an Odin AI tools piece. As you can see here, the Odin AI tools piece can help with a bunch of different simple tasks. And one of those right on top is the Get LinkedIn Profile task, which is exactly what we're going to be using this for. Since we've used the simple agent to optimize our input query, let's go ahead and use that output here. We can set a limit on how many profiles this step is going to fetch. I'm going to set this to 10 right now. And we can also mention specific URLs that you don't want showing up on the chat. Again, don't forget to test any piece that you're adding to your automated flow. Finally, we'll need our flow to fetch each of these individual URLs from this piece and display it on our chat. For that, we're going to be running a loop. This loop will run for every URL that's generated by the Odin AI tools piece. So let's go ahead and insert this as the criteria here. Once we test this piece, we can go ahead and add a response card inside the loop. The response card is used to provide an update on the progress of our flow. In this example, we're going to use it to fetch the URLs from the Odin AI tools piece and display it on our chat. So let's go ahead and select the send message action. Let's include the specific URL from the loop. And now let's test this step as well. Now let's go a step further and see if we can actually pull any email IDs that are associated to these profiles to make our task easier. We're once again going to turn to our extremely handy friend, the Odin AI tools piece, but this time we'll set the action to seek contact. We'll use the LinkedIn email finder API for this. And again, this is specific to the URL that's currently being used by our loop. And now that we've tested all of our pieces, let's go ahead and publish this flow. Now let's navigate to the Actions tab on the left panel, and you'll see the flow that we've just built. Now let's try it out and see if it works. As you can see, our flow works perfectly and it's giving us actual candidate profiles directly from LinkedIn based on our search. We hope you found this tutorial helpful, but if you have any questions or need further assistance, feel free to reach out to our support team, who'll be happy to help. Happy recruiting!